was a pleasure with all you had on your mind. Did you get any sleep? Until about 5:30 this morning when the phone rang. It had to do with the Philippines.
Figured it might. We thoroughly
had done. He was on the other end with John on the phone call, so he too is suffering.
You both look fine for that early. We have a little different mood this year with the governors. Even the Democrats, I think, are recognizing that we're accepting our new responsibilities, not wringing our hands very much. And the reporters ask me what the mood is. I say, well, we can raise taxes too. We have to. We want to make it easier, not harder, for you to balance the budget. And I wanted you to know that before you saw all of them.
All right. All of
them. Okay.
I appreciate that. I also wanted to show you something, if I may, and I'll just take a minute. This is a book I'm doing about Japan and Tennessee, which is coming out in May. And I put in here a little article that the Washington Post carried about it. It comes out of a series of trips I've made there over the last 7 or 8 years. Tennessee's become the state with more Japanese capital investment than any other state, and I've been there 7 or 8 times. And I wanted to plant in your mind thought and
subject day comes around the other side of the world. It's a place down south of us here called Nicaragua. You may have heard of it, but we've had an interest in it here. But I understand seriously the concerns that some of you have, and some of you think of but not think of it as you're disturbed by a request that it be covert and so forth. I just have to tell you that everything that is going on down there requires us to continue this assistance, and this time real assistance, not just non-lethal, to the freedom fighters. We have met at 9 different times with the Sandinista government to try and negotiate and discuss about having a negotiated settlement. Let's take the issue first of whether that Sandinista government, whether we are interfering with a legitimate government. We're not. There was a revolution against the Somoza. The Sandinistas were probably the oldest and actually organized group in that revolution. And they were, their philosophy was communist. Others joined. There was a general revolution. Our country, we weren't around at the time, but our country stayed out, did not stand up for Somoza. And then the revolutionaries asked the Organization of American States, they wouldn't appeal to Somoza to step down and end the killing. And they asked for a statement of what was the revolution about, what were they trying to achieve. And they got the statement. It was democracy. It was all the things that we believe in, freedom of press and human rights and pluralistic government, people with freedom of speech and assembly and so forth. And Somoza did stand revolution was apparently over. And then the Sandinistas, being organized as they were, and we've seen it happen before, we saw it happen in Laos, and we insisted on them